Welcome to Analytics with Nags. In this video, we're going to see about how to embed a Power BI reports in a web page or how to export the Power BI reports. We are exploring Power BI using a business scenario. Today, the Naga Garments having some questions, and we are going to relate the concepts of how to when he has to embed and when he has to export the reports. So he wants to embed the Power BI reports to the internal web portal. So no need to log in for new Power BI website. Basically, Naga Garments having employed 10 to 15 employees, and they having internal website. And to see the reports, there are 5 to 6 people are accessing the reports. And to see the report, they want to go to Power BI reports instead of logging into internal websites. Internal website that is for the HRMS or their daily statuses or offers. They have their own website. They want to embed that report in the Power BI reports. If it is embedded in the internal website, then no need of going for Power BI reports. So this is one of the important option they want to go for it. So that is where they want to embed the reports. There will be another scenario, like the manager of the Naga Garments want to present a financial report as a presentation to the stakeholders. In that case, he wants to take a snapshot of it or try to export it. Then he has to put it in a PowerPoint or PDF files. He has to manually do it. Take a snapshot or picture of it and doing it. The Power BI has a default option of it. That is what I'm going to show it to you, how to export the report. Let's explore these two things in a demo. If you're new to this channel, hit the subscribe button right now to learn the concepts in Power BI. So first we will see how to embed the report. So I have reports here, and let us try to explore this particular report. That is our first report. And you have a lot of options in the file menu, like embed, embed in SharePoint, publish to web, export everything. So this embed and embed SharePoint online more or less similar. The difference I'll show. So here the embed code will show you the iframe version of it and the URL version of it. Okay, whereas your embed with SharePoint online, that will give only the URL version of it. So let us go for, if you have a SharePoint online, if the Naga Garments has the SharePoint online for the internal purpose, then we need to go for this. In this case, we will go for this option. Let me copy this URL. And this code has to be embedded, okay, as part of iframe or any other website. So in my case, I don't have any website. So let me go on to new URL. And assuming this is a new website, and let us put this one. This code has to be there in the web page, internal web page. Now you can see, like, whoever accessing this web page should also to be logged in. Okay, that is the prerequisite. That is what embed will not just like that will allow. Whoever has access to that website cannot access it. Basically, they need to be logged in. So it's asking, please sign in to view this report, right? So it requires access. Let us sign in. So now you see it is, I'm putting the URL in the web page. That is why it's asking the Power BI login. Otherwise, it might have asked only the web page login. If they're having an internal website that has a login, then that will ask only that. Let me give the password. There you go. Once he signs in, then he can able to see the report using this web page. So that is embedded. So now in this page, if in this web page, whatever the code can be, you can have any other side window that is purely based on the web side designing, all the functionalities will work as such. So basically you will get embed code, then you need to use. This is embed, SharePoint and embed. There is something like publish to web. This option, we will take it later in other videos. And let us move on to the second point. Export to PowerPoint, export to PDF. So why we need to export? Basically, you have this URL and you can need to access the report. But sometimes what happens, we need to present it to the management. We need to present the figures or the graphs. Okay. In that case, people during the meetings, we do not have access to the internet. Just we need to put it in a PPT as snapshot. So that is the option. These options will be useful in those cases. Let me try to export it as a PDF. If it contains multiple pages, do that. If you want to export only the current page, then click on this. By default, if you have multiple pages, it will export all the pages. Now it is exporting it to PowerPoint. So once it is exported, let us open it and see it as well. Okay, it got downloaded. Let us open it. It's opening. So it gives the initial page as well, along with the report. So this is our snapshot of it. So it is nothing but just an image or snapshot of your object. Okay, it will not have anything, just it will not interact. Okay, that is the main difference. So previous option, if you have seen, that will interact, right? I mean, if you click on it, it will also filter everything, but it is just an image kind of thing, just a snapshot. Okay, that is the main difference you need to understand here. Okay guys, let me quickly export it to PDF. So just it is same as that, just click on PDF, then it will export it as a PDF. Okay, I already opened it here. So it's like now you have a PDF version of it. Okay, this is your PDF, and here also it is name. You have something like you cannot interact, just a screenshot of your report. I hope you guys understand it. So the options available over here: embed, embed in SharePoint, export, export PDF. Publish to web is outside the organization, and anybody outside your organization, it's a public access. No, anyone in the internet can access it. So that option we will explore it later. If you like this video, share and subscribe to the channel. Comment below for your queries. Do remember that data is your asset.